Okay, I'm going to put two 120 mil fans on the top of the case here to see if I could cool it down. I did this a couple days ago before I got the CPU cooler. The CPU cooler fixed everything, but I did want to put two fans up there prior to see if that would do anything. Here's the motherboard. It's a Geo Byte motherboard. And there's three connectors for fans. There's one on the corner here, one over here by the power, and then one all the way on the bottom. They're all called like System Fan 1, System Fan 2, System Fan 3. So there's three that aren't being used right now. The two fans I bought had Molex connectors, and they were three-pin fans. So I really couldn't use the three-pin. These are four-pin connectors on the motherboard. You have to get a four-pin fan if you're going to go directly to the motherboard. So in my video, I'm going to show you in a couple minutes here. I have the two fans that I put on top connected to the Molex cable in the back. And that was just to see what kind of temperatures I can get out of this thing with running two extra fans on top. I have already switched the side fans in the back here to intake from exhaust, and it had no effect on the temperatures. I had done a video on that already. So this video is going to show you basically what the fans look like when in this top portion of the case here, and I'm going to give you the results of the temperatures. These from Best Buy as well. They were $13. I'll also point to the CPU fan connectors. There's one over here in the corner. And there's one here by this cable. System fan 2, I think. And then there's one under the video card, which you can't see because the video card's there, but there is another one there. So there's three connectors on the motherboard. If I was going to do this long term, I'd probably use the connectors on the motherboard. They are four pins. I just put the Molex cable because it was quick and easy, so I'll show you that portion now. So here's the two fans I put in the top. I tried both directions, had no effect on the temperatures. Plugged it into the bottom there. They have a like a totem pole of Molexes, and I just added two more Molex connectors for this thing. They're cool fans. I mean, I wouldn't mind keeping them, but if they don't do anything, I don't see a reason to use the power, actually. You just take the cover off and you can screw them in. They're easy. So on this Cyber power machine, I flipped the two side fans, like most people say in the forums, and I actually added two large 120 millimeter fans on top as exhaust. And still I'm getting those high temperature readings. So the only solution we have is to replace this cooler on this CPU, and that's what I'm going to probably wind up doing.
Okay, I did like the forum said, and I reversed the fans that are on the side that come with the case, and I made them from exhaust to intake, and I didn't see any temperature changes on a CPU anyway. Then I put two 120 mil fans on top, and I ran them as exhaust, and I also tried them as intakes, and I didn't see any temperature changes. I'm going to leave the side fans reversed as intakes, but I'm not going to bother with the top fan.